Okay. My goal is to drive everybody out of the room by offending them one thing or another.
We should wait until after Marilyn passes the basket.
They never accuse me of being good for business. I'll do one more song and then we'll take a break and then we got more, right? Is that about right?
Sure. As you wish.
I was at a march on May 1st, 2000 in Manhattan, and there were 5,000 people marching, and about 98% of them were from Mexico or Central America, and there were about 5,000 cops, and they had so many motorcycles, they were literally falling over each other. And the cops were on the average about a foot taller than the marchers. And so you couldn't see the marchers unless you were in the march. But there were 5,000 of them. And I went to this march thinking it was going to be about amnesty for undocumented workers, which maybe it was originally supposed to be. But in any case, the vast majority of the marchers had signs that they had handmade that were written in English that said, "Workers of the World Unite." And the police were guarding all the McDonald's and all the Starbucks and the World Trade Center on that day in case we might throw a rock. But there were only like 200 anarchist types at the march, and they were planning on shutting down Wall Street, which didn't happen because there were 5,000 cops and only 200 of them. But the cops actually shut down Wall Street for us because they had all these these barriers that come up out of the ground. They shut down the whole thing just because of 200 people who showed up because back then if you put something on the web, the police thought that it was going to be like Seattle, because Seattle was like, they weren't expecting that. So then after that they were like, oh, they're not paying attention, and then so somebody put up a website, so they figured Wall Street was doomed, but. It wasn't, unfortunately. Clouds gather in your forest. Drift to my desert town. And I think of far off places as the rain is coming down. You're bent down in the fields, picking fruit there from the vine. And it ends up on my table. Shines brightly in the night sky. The river flows from south to north. With the changing of the seasons, the birds migrate back and forth. But they say that you can't come here, not in the light of day. Somebody has got plans for you. Start at home or hide away. Traveled across these borders, so much is bought and sold. One way goes the gunships, the other comes the gold. Free trade is like a needle, drawing blood straight from your heart. The border's like a prison, keeping friends apart. Will we open up the borders? Prison walls declare that no one is illegal. Watch the giant as it falls. Getting smaller, hear the drowning child crying. Why are the fences growing taller? Some whisper in the shadows, while others count the dollars. Some have suits and ties. A fortress walls come down. May we meet our sisters and our brothers. Stand arm in arm there in the daylight. No longer fighting one another. Will we stand together? For therein lies our might. Will we understand these words? Workers of the world, unite. Will we open up the borders? Tear down the prison walls, declare that no one is illegal. No one is illegal. No one is illegal.
People keep asking me where I live, and I say I'm from Portland, and they say, oh, what a beautiful city. So let me tell you something about Portland. This is a song about Portland.
We're just there last week.
I grew up in the suburbs, the ones where you do not stay. Either get rich when you grow up, or else you move away. Made a life in Boston. It was a wonderful city before they turned it into a theme park for just the young and pretty. When they abolished rent control, I was living there. That's when the city lost its soul. People scattered everywhere. I don't know where they went, but they were rapidly replaced. Generations of communities entirely erased. I lived in San Francisco when the mayor swept the streets. I wasn't the kind of guy he wanted the tourists to meet. I moved to Seattle when Bill Gates and Kurt Cobain made the place the capital of the hipster rave train. Now PDX, it's a CD on repeat. Developers smelled money, now they're in the driver's seat. Whole neighborhoods bulldozed as landlords tripled the rent for so many, if not most. I'll tell you what that's meant. Goodbye. Goodbye, Portland. Goodbye. Goodbye, Portland town. Any city change is only natural, I'd surmise. This will happen faster when no one controls the rise of the prices of the houses and the interest rates of the month-to-month agreements in 48 states. Where it's not allowed to do what other countries do, where there are limits to the landlords, what they can do to you. Limits to their profits and to what they can destroy, so you might recognize the place you lived in as a boy. Goodbye. Goodbye, Portland. USA, we're moving beyond race. And why did half the African Americans leave the place between one census and the next one? 10 years later, it's like a bomb went off, but no one could find a crater. There wasn't any war here, just a lack of regulation. And folks would see a city as a source of wealth creation. A chance to make it big, a chance to make a buck. If you don't fit into their fortune making, they don't give a fuck. Goodbye. Goodbye, Portland town. Goodbye. Goodbye, Portland town. Goodbye. Goodbye, Portland town. Goodbye. Goodbye, Portland town.
Landlord is one of the problems, and I've been writing songs for my landlord for months now in a continual effort to avoid strangling him. So I figure as soon as I stop writing songs about my desire to strangle him, then I will do so. Writing because among the choices it's probably better than listening to voices raging in my head saying point and shoot. Then after you're dead, your face meets my boot. I don't know your name, it's better that way, because I can't play this game. Who knows what I'll say? I feel like I'm burning, I've had it up to here. It's time that you were learning the meaning of fear. I live in these apartments and your private property among your residents. Most of us agree that you're a piece of shit. How does that make you feel? We don't like it one bit, and that's for real. We think you're a thief, that you don't care. Seems you want relief, whatever the market will bear. Whatever you can get away with, what you can make us pay. If we ever get justice, you should fear that day, landlord. But it's not just you, it's all your kin. The things you do cause the state we're in. You bribe the politicians so they let you off me. Now the legal situation's just the one you need. For you to make millions, for profits to be high. But even billions won't be with you when you die. I hope you find a death you seek. Meet the devil that you serve. If you live another week, that's more life than you deserve. Landlord. Landlord. For your waging, there's no question who is winning. But if there's any justice, this is only the beginning. The next act in the play will be written by the tenants. And until your dying day, you'll be paying penance. Your assets will be seized, that's a given. You profiteers of misery, start spending time in prison. Then you can get a job, figure out what you do best. You can keep the house you live in, but we're taking all the rest. Landlord.
As long as he sings about it, it's
got all kinds of intent. my invisible to my first and only love. She's white as any lily and gentle as a dove. She threw her arms around me saying, Johnny, I love you still. She's met the farmer's daughter and the bride of Spencer Hill. I dreamed I stooped and kissed her as in the days of yore. She said, Johnny, you're only joking, as many's the time before. The rooster crowed in the morning, he crowed both loud and shrill. And I woke in California, many miles from Spencer Hill. I behold the state I'm in, and I love you all you are, cause nothing's changed for me, and like everybody here, I'm so glad that you could make it so good to have you near. For your words I laugh and cry, and as I look around I'm sure I'm surrounded by your lovers, only one of them. But nothing's changed for me, I still yearn for your embrace. Sometimes I close my eyes, then I gaze upon your face. I know everything must end, but I remember our last kiss. I recall your parting glance, and there's so much more I miss. Cause nothing's changed for me, except you went away. You're moving on, and I'm stuck in yesterday. So I'll wish you all that's good, and I'll make a toast for you, for all the places you may travel, for whatever you may do. Cause nothing's changed for me, I'm still in love so much. I know I'll be okay, but I miss your gentle touch. There are songs for victories, songs for things that fall apart. This is just a song for my broken heart.
Song about a politician. This one is currently in office. I was inspired by the Republican debates in 2012. They were talking about somebody, and he sounded so cool until I realized who they were talking about. But I wrote a song. My TV, though it was hard to see these men who would be head of state. What a great country, from sea to shining sea, we watched the Republicans debate. Newt stood with his third wife and said, "You bet your life the president is a red. He wants to tax the rich a lot, take your limo and your yacht. He wants to have the bankers' heads. And if he gets in again, he'll paint the White House pink, and then he'll hire Chavez as his VP. Then we'll be right on track to give capitalism the sack, along with the insurance industry. If only it were true, if only it were true, and he's so happy, wouldn't you? If only it were true, if only it were true, if only it were true. He'll give everyone food stamps and wheelchair ramps. He'll subsidize windmills and maple syrup. He'll cripple industries with eco-friendly policies, and pretty soon we will be just like Europe. He'll shut down oil wells, give out solar cells to every home in Delaware and Illinois. He'll ban logging in the parks and send the works of Karl Marx to the homes of every American girl and boy. He'll abolish pesticides, he'll be giving out free rides and free lunches to his high-speed trains. He'll start lots of public works full of union perks. He'll fill all the cities up with bicycle lanes. If only it were true, if only it were true, I'd be so happy, wouldn't you? If only it were true, if only it were true, if only it were true. Watch out, his critics tell. This shall be our death knell. He'll pull the troops out and end all of our wars. He'll cut military spending. Our empire will be ending, and soon we'll be invaded by the Moors. He'll legalize all drugs, give away beer mugs and hookahs to every child and Korans. He'll ban religions from the schools, give 40 acres and a mule to every person who makes less than 50 grand. He'll close Guantanamo to torture, he'll say no. He'll make us all drive electric cars. He'll reinstate the fairness doctrine, take off the damn flag pin, and he'll put Rupert Murdoch behind bars. If only it were true, if only it were true, I'd be so happy, wouldn't you? Thus your huddled masses, yearning to be free. That's what it says, the Statue of Liberty, here they come. From the other side, across the southern border, across the great divide, and now they're told they should go away. But the statue in the harbor says stay. Give us your cold and hungry, let them come by land or sea. Let them all find solace in this land of refugees, escaping persecution, just trying to survive. And they worked as hard as Guatemalans as soon as their ships arrived, and now they're told they should go away. But the statue in the harbor says stay. Give us your persecuted, but only if they're white. It doesn't say that on the statue that holds aloft the light. What did you think would happen in the lands you overthrew? Where should all the children go after the coup? Now they're told they should go away. But the statue in the harbor says stay. Now they're told they should go away. But the statue in the harbor says stay. The statue in the harbor says stay.
This is David Rovics. And I would believe he has at least one more song in him. Yeah, go ahead. I mean, after the revolution or anything you like.
Something optimistic.
Optimistic. That's a very optimistic song.
Here's my social change. How social change happens in 3 minutes. You don't need to go to the Marxist conferences. Just listen to the song. Realizing they're like you, they're holding the same card. Step three is black, there's a tactic when everyone believes it could be true. That if all the people were collected, we, there just might be something we can do, and everything could change. So quick. TV said so, try hard to make sure it isn't, so you don't have a problem. If you do, it's not the same problem. And if it is, there is just nowhere you can go. But it's happened many times. The history is rich, though we easily forget how a meme can take hold and grab you, how it can spread out like a net, and everything can change. So say we are lost, or we're dreaming, or they'll make a dream for us. They'll try to come up with a good story about why we belong at the back of the bus, about why we belong in this position, about how we don't know what we meant, about how there most certainly isn't any such thing as a 99%, but everything can change. So
David's song.